Fieldtech FY3000 200S signal generator and counter. This is the documentation of the experience of a hobby project, made with the hope that it could be helpful to others. But any comment that could help me to improve my practice is also welcome and appreciated. Unlike most of the other videos in this series, this particular one shows a very simple repair process, and there is no extra written documentation attached to it. This is a cheap, common, and fairly useful signal generator and frequency counter. One should know that the internal power supply might have a small leakage of energy from the mains to the ground of the output ports, and if not connected to an external ground, this leakage might damage other delicate electronics. During a distant thunderstorm, while the item was powered on, at a certain point, it made the sound of a small burst, and it stopped working. It turned out that the power supply was damaged and some components appeared to have signs of burns. The controller or M6203 was ordered and later a repair was attempted. The components visibly broken or with external burn signs are removed and tested when in doubt. This is the controller RM6203. This is the diode D6 type FR107. This is the optocoupler type EL817. The diode and the optocoupler seem to be still operational, and they are installed back on the board. Also, the new controller RM6203 is installed. The original fuse was blown. It was a slow blow 2 amps fuse. It is replaced with a common 20 millimeters long, slow blow glass fuse rated 1.25 amps, adapting it for soldering it on the board, but adding some insulation. The other components were tested in circuit, and nothing else seemed to be damaged. The board is connected again to the mains and the power switch for testing it. The output voltages are checked carefully for not making shorts while testing them. Without load, the output voltages appear slightly higher than what they are supposed to be. The power supply board is connected temporarily with the rest of the unit for testing it in circuit. Everything seems okay. Therefore, it is time to put some screws and close the small cabinet again. Luckily, the repair was easy and the unit is at its usual place on the bench, operational again.